This New York City restaurant chain prides itself on its burgers. Since opening in 2008, it's served old-fashioned veggie patties alongside its beef offerings. 2 years ago, it introduced the plant-based Impossible Burger to the menu. And today, Five Napkins says its two meatless burgers make up 20% of sales.
Well, they definitely sell. I mean, they sell about equally. So they're, you know, the whole, as a percentage, like the non-beef burgers that we sell has gone up since we've added the Impossible Burger and has gone up over the years.
Americans have long had a love affair with meat. And on average, each person consumes more than 90 kilograms each year. But these days, substitute meat is not only found on the menus of upscale restaurants, but in supermarkets and fast food chains across the country. Burger King introduced the Impossible Whopper last August. Dunkin' serves Beyond Meat's plant-based sausages in its breakfast sandwiches. In the latest sign that meat alternatives are going mainstream, McDonald's has announced it'll introduce a plant-based burger in 2021. Products like these are designed to appeal to both vegetarians and meat eaters who are looking to adopt a more healthy diet.
There's a lot of interest in plant-based diets, especially because they're being recommended as those that are best for health and for the environment. So there's a big interest. Obviously, there's a big market for it. That's why all these investment capital companies are pouring in this money, all that money into these products.
Market research firm Euromonitor International expects U.S. sales of meat substitutes to grow 168% from 2015 to 2020. An investment firm UBS projects the plant-based meat market will reach $85 billion in annual sales in the next decade. One major selling point is that the production of meat substitutes is more sustainable.
Beef is the food that produces the most, that's responsible for the largest proportion of greenhouse gas emissions of any other food in the food supply, largely because of the enormous amounts of food that have to be grown to feed the animals.
According to Impossible Foods, producing one of its plant-based burgers uses 96% less land, 87% less water, and 89% less carbon emissions than a beef patty. But while these plant-based products may be more environmentally friendly, they're not necessarily cheaper.
The Impossible Burger and Beyond and the other substitutes, they are expensive. As you know, raw material product, we actually pay more per ounce than we pay for our beef, which, as you know, the price is starting to come down now that there's more supply and more competitors.
Five Napkins says it's looking to expand its meat-free section of the menu in the new year. And as more consumers seek out healthy, sustainable alternatives, perhaps the normalization of meatless meat is not so impossible after all. Kyoko Gasha, TRT World, New York.